The seashell is a hard protective outer layer created by an animal that lives in the sea, and this shell is part of the body of the animal. Empty seashells are often found washed up on beaches by beachcombers. The shells are empty because the animal had died and the soft parts have been eaten by another animal or have rotted out. Prince Jeremiah Ekane, a creative artist, is from the south-south region of Nigeria, Akwa Ibom State. His father was a soldier who served in the Nigerian army during the Biafran War.
I'm from Obotokara, local government area of Akwa Ibom State. My father was a soldier. He served the Nigerian army during the Nigeria-Biafra Civil War. Actually, one of the 63 NAs. He served under the 81 Division, S&T Bonny Camp, Victoria Island, here in Lagos State. He retired from the army in 1989.
Born without a silver spoon from our humble family of six, he dropped out of school in search of menial jobs in spite of the free education back then in Lagos State.
I've always regretted in the first place that I dropped out of school. And that was because my parents were illiterate. They were not there to encourage me, because I still remember that then in Lagos State, there was free education. When I dropped out of school, I looked at it that what I was doing was not enough to send me to the classroom. Because as of this time I'm talking about, the school system was now money demanding. So I had to start going into menial jobs to survive. Because by that time, I was no more with my parents, who were already, aging.
Battling the idea of still going back to school, Jeremiah had the military up his sleeves.
I actually wanted to go into the Nigerian army because then I had someone who was ready to help me, even though I had no academic qualification. But for the fact that I was, fit physically, I had somebody who was willing to help me at least to enlist into the army as a recruit. But then, because I'd always been God-fearing, I had to seek the consent of God first before I go into the army. And it was then I discovered that the army was not for me.
With the military down the drain, his quest for furthering his education took him to a Bible institute.
I dropped the idea of going into the army, and instead, I studied theology for 3 years, where I had my diploma with Overcomers Bible Institute and Seminary. And after that, I started practicing back far back in Port Harcourt.
School of Theology? How then did the art business come to be? What inspired the use of seashells for his art designs?
The inspiration of this business came to me on the island, because I actually sought the face of God to help me, get something doing as a man. And then he revealed to me that there are gold, there are diamonds, there are silver on this island. And these things were the seashells that you're seeing around me today.
Is the business lucrative?
I wouldn't say I make good money from here, because a lot of people are still skeptical about the job, since they don't really have idea of what this kind of art is all about, or maybe because they don't really have money to get this thing. I don't know, but I'm not really making money from there for now.
Do people understand the value of this kind of art with seashells?
This is a new kind of art in town. People are used to painting, carving, sculptures, but this is quite different from all that. This is natural. So only few people understand what I'm doing. So we are trying to bring it to the people so that they can also understand that treasures are not only in diamond, in gold, in oil, but are also in seashells.
In taking a tour around Jeremiah's gallery, I discovered that the seashells are not only used for art designs, it has other societal benefits.
Apart from the art aspect of seashells, seashells can also be used for interior and exterior decorations. Seashells can also be used for livestock feed.
In acquiring the seashells, Jeremiah dives into the sea to get the shells, while some of the shells are washed down to the seashore.
Now, naturally, when I go for seashells, I gather everything together. And so when I come, I wash them, sun dry them, and then begin to separate them one by one, which will now link us to the main base. So let's go there. Seeing here now, looks like rubbles. But I want to surprise you by saying that this is actually used for chicken feed. This is the bone meal that is used for chicken feed, pig feed, snail feed. By the time it is grinded, mixed with the other ingredients, the chickens are already ready to feed. This particular shell has been discovered that it pushed the pH of water in the fish pond. A lot of people have been coming for these particular ones. They get into a container or a bag, a sack bag, and then they put it inside the pond. These other kind of shells here can be used for interior and exterior decorations. Now, like this one here, you can actually fit this into a wall. You could also fix this one. You could fix this one. You could fix this one, or any of these, as long as they are shells. You fix them into walls, they are standing and they remain there forever, and they beautify the house. Or you could fix them into frames. They are standing. They are still for interior or exterior decorations. You can also use them to decorate your flower pots. These stones could also be used for interior decorations. They could be used for exterior decorations. They could be placed in museums. These stones could be kept in schools. These are the seaweed. These grew up in the sea. They were shaped by the sea. Their formation came as a mystery because no physical hands were there to shape these. So this tells us that there's something unique about these roots. It's only for us to preserve them for generations to come to see and know what is really happening in the sea. These are sea-baked wood. They are actually, I call them sea-baked wood because they look baked. I can break this one now, but I won't break it because it's my money. Okay, but they are baked. They are very fragile in nature. These also could be kept in museums. It could be kept in schools to teach our children of what we have in the sea. There's a lot of people who come to this gallery. They have a mystical view in mind, as in they feel that some of these things have spirits that could actually help people out in one problem or the other. But I want to correct that error, that none of these things here have spirit. These things are lifeless things. They are like dead bodies. They do not communicate. They don't have the ability to communicate. Seashells, sea stones, sea wood, sea whatever, do not have spirits to communicate. They are just material things that we appreciate as part of God's creation.
What? Spirit, so much for human beings.
Apart from what I explained to you earlier, seashells can also be used for necklace. Like what you're seeing in my hand here, it's a beautiful necklace for a beautiful woman or a handsome man like me. You see what I'm wearing now? I also have bangles made of necklace shells too. Like what I'm wearing here is three
different bangles. They are all made of seashells. It's for unisex, and you can also have the earring as a woman. This is also part of the work, but there's something unique about this particular shell. This is a broken shell. Some of us think a broken shell is a broken dream, but I'm here to prove us wrong, because a broken shell is not a broken dream. That's the meaning of this, that no matter how a man's life has been broken, there is still beauty in it if only he can make use of his mind. So that's what you're seeing here. I can also wear this and go for a very good occasion, and I know those beautiful girls living out there are going to admire it.